McCoyan, U152. Alan Wilson. In the dead heat for air speed superiority during the Cold War, the Soviet Union developed two single-engine test fighters. Their purpose was to see how far they could push their own envelope when it came to world records. The game, back then, was to see who could get there first, drop a payload, and scurry out. The U-152 seemed like a promising chance for the Soviet Union to catch up to fighter craft like the F-100, F-101, and the F-106. But the U-152 turned out to be little more than a good show. With a maximum achieved speed of Mach 2.8+, it definitely had pure velocity in its corner. However, with engine reliability and combat viability both proverbially up in the air, the U-152 went no further than simply making the world record charts for fastest jets in 1959. The Soviet Union would eventually figure out that in the E-150 family, two engines may be better than one. The U-152A used a much more reliable R-11 wind turbojet design, which enabled it to withstand the stresses of sustained supersonic flight much better. Unfortunately, this test craft was terminated after it crashed in 1965. Top speed, 1,883 miles per hour. Max flight distance, 913 miles. North American XB-70 Valkyrie. NASA. The XB-70 Valkyrie is an impressive military aircraft whose legacy would wind up being something totally different than what it set out to accomplish. The Valkyrie was originally built to be the baddest manned strategic bomber ever known. It was an exciting concept with a planned cruise speed of Mach 3 at altitudes of around 70,000 feet. The design not only looked cool, the wing structure is what theoretically would make the aircraft perform so well. All the while, there was another aviation arena garnering a lot of attention known as supersonic transport. It just so happened that the size and material of the XB-70 Valkyrie was ideal for testing SSD. Thus its purpose was then officially changed from manned bomber to research aircraft. Its early test flights provided a lot of valuable information for SSD designers, including aircraft noise and the reliability of wind tunnel predictions versus actual flight findings. Unfortunately, there were two casualties during the testing of this aircraft, which complicated the program. It remains one of the most valuable research planes ever made. Top speed, 2,050 miles per hour. Max flight distance, 3,725 miles on internal fuel. The MiG-25 Foxbat. Leonid Fairberg. Right as the F-4 Phantom II was just getting its proverbial wings underneath it, the Soviet Union had its own competitor to air superiority in mind, the MiG-25 Foxbat. It was designed as a pure-speed, super-maneuverable supersonic interceptor. When it hit the skies in 1964, NATO allies didn't even know what hit them. The F-4 Phantom II was the latest the Air Force had for air superiority aircraft, and it was literally toe-to-toe with these new MiG-25s over northern Vietnam. As a testament to great engineering at an affordable price, there are still MiG-25s in service, even though many of them were upgraded into the MiG-31. In terms of competition for speed in the air, the only aircraft that had the Foxbat licked was the State Route 71 Blackbird, a coveted reconnaissance asset during the 1970s and 80s. Top speed, 2,170 miles per hour. Max flight distance, 1,075 miles on internal fuel. The Lockheed YF-12. U.S. Air Force. This was the experimental Lockheed Martin aircraft that would go on to influence the design of the highly successful and versatile State Route 71 Blackbird. Designed back in the early 60s, it proved to be an out-of-the-box platform that absolutely smashed all previously held records for flight speed. Shrouded in secrecy, many people forget that the origins of this program were the very first for actual stealth technology. Capable of high-altitude missions at an incredible Mach 3.35 speed, this supersonic jet fighter was meant to bring futuristic sci-fi capabilities to the contemporary present. Though the program was defunded, Lockheed would take all the lessons learned from its brief lifespan to influence the production of the State Route 71. The State Route 71 would go on to serve quite famously as a high-altitude reconnaissance aircraft. Top speed, 2,275 miles per hour. Max flight distance, 3,000 miles. State Route 71 Blackbird. NASA. Lockheed Martin broke the mold when it created this space-age, high-altitude stealth aircraft. Originally developed under the YF-12 Interceptor program, the State Route 71 Blackbird absolutely smashed world records for airspeed time and time again. As a reconnaissance aircraft with no communications uplink, it had a very limited role in strategic surveillance. But it really bloomed in the hearts and minds of aerospace enthusiasts. Crushing a maximum speed record of 2,500 miles per hour, the State Route 71 Blackbird could skirt the very edge of the atmosphere at 85,000 feet. Awarded multiple distinctions for achievements in aeronautic design, performance, and versatility, the stealth aircraft could barely be seen and never hit. The Soviet MiG-25 Foxbat was the only aircraft in service that could approach catching up to the State Route 71, and even it had a very difficult time trailing behind this legendary stealth aircraft. Top speed, 2,500 miles per hour. Max flight distance, 3,337 miles on internal fuel. Boeing X-51 Scramjet. U.S. Air Force. The advantage of modern technology is not having to risk an actual pilot's life to test the utter barriers of new scramjet wave rider technology. The wave rider is the love child of DARPA, the United States Air Force, and several other bleeding-edge aeronautic programs. It's an unmanned aerial craft meant to be deployed in air, much like how the North American X-15 was deployed from the back of a B-52 Stratofortress. The X-51 is much smaller because, unlike the X-15, it doesn't have to support a human pilot. Capable of recorded speeds above the Mach 5 mark, this highly experimental craft is designed to be pushed into service around 2030, where it will ideally serve as a platform for a fast attack missile. With a range of 460 miles, a B-52 Stratofortress just needs to get within a 500-mile range of target before it could deploy the X-51 and then safely return back to base. Top speed, 3,900 miles per hour. Max flight distance, 460 miles. The X-43. NASA. Furthering the pursuits of space travel, NASA has breached the limits of what is currently the fastest recorded air travel with the fastest jet. The X-43 breached the Mach 9.6 barrier in an unmanned flight. High-velocity travel was possible by using a booster rocket to get to the right speed and altitude. Cutting-edge scramjet technology takes over from there. The X-43 program has come under a lot of scrutiny in terms of design and expenditure, but it has ultimately solved the question of how fast. As with all experimental X designators, the X-43 is designed to push the limits further than previous testing has allowed. Scramjet technology began development in the 1950s, but there is still a lot to be learned. Top speed, 6,598 miles per hour.